This is Victor Jones of IAU, Indie Artists United, and we're so excited to have Cynthia Cooper with us today for this IAU interview. How are you, Ms. Cooper?
I'm doing great. How are you? Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it.
No problem. No problem. It's an honor for us to have you here at IAU with us, and we're going to go through an interview today with Ms. Cooper. She's a great, awesome, dynamic singer. She's worked with a lot of people in the R&B world, and we're just so excited to have her here today, and we look forward to hearing some great things from Cynthia Cooper. So we're going to jump into this interview, Ms. Cooper. First, tell us where you're from, and tell us a little bit about your music journey.
I'm originally from New Jersey, but right now I'm a country girl. I'm living in Wilson, North Carolina. I've been here about 6 years taking care of my mother who's recovering from back surgery. My musical journey started with my dad. My dad was a music teacher, and when I grew up, every time we had company, we'd have like a little talent show. We had to sing for everybody. I joined, my dad was a choir director, a band director. So he taught me how to play the piano. He taught me how to sing. And I sang with a lot of different choirs, and I grew up singing with my brother. And then my first professional job was singing background for Billy Paul. Then I worked with Patti LaBelle, Teddy Pendergrass, the Orlans. And I was working with the Orlans, but my mother got sick and I had to come off a tour. And then with the pandemic, nobody's singing right now. But right now I'm currently working on a gospel CD. I have a new website, CindyCooperMusic.com. where all of my songs are on there. And I'm also worked on a club tune. I have a club tune out that is doing well in the UK. It's in, doing well in London.
Okay.
And that's about it, yeah.
Okay, well.
So I'm looking forward to doing some great things in the music.
You said that's about it, like that's a little bit. No, that's a lot. And we appreciate you gracing us with your presence in this interview.
Oh, I'm honored to be here.
And also with your presence on the app, we believe that your presence is going to make a difference in our variety of music and our variety of music experience at IAU. So we want to say thank you again for joining us for this interview and also on the app. So we're going to move into the song that we're going to highlight today during this interview. And I'm so glad. I'm going to play it first so that we can get a wind of the dynamical voice that you have, and then we're going to talk about it. Is that okay, Cindy?
Okay, absolutely.
Here we go.
I'm so glad that Jesus
I can feel the Holy Spirit up in here.
All right now.
So we're gonna stop right there. Oh my gosh, we're gonna finish the interview. Oh, buddy, I can feel the spirit up in this place.
All right, hallelujah.
And I know, yes, Lord, that was awesome.
Oh, gosh. Thank you. Yeah, a friend of mine, Ernie Heron, wrote that. We grew up at the same church, Kawarta Asbury United Methodist Church.
Okay,
he wrote that, and that was originally released on Priority Records years ago.
Okay.
That's Domino's daughter, Karen Domino White. She had a record called Karen Domino White and Friends, and my song was released on there. But then I got signed with Sang Entertainment, and we put out a 12 songs album, and this song was included, and that's why I'm bringing that out again. I just recently signed with REG Entertainment.
It's worth the while to bring it back out again because.
Yes.
I'm so glad. I just got glad. If I was mad, I just got glad.
Amen.
And so yeah. I'll tell you something.
It's a good feeling to know that God saved me. Yes, so glad.
Lord, have mercy.
Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. I want to tell the world. I remember when I first got saved, I wanted everybody to get saved. It's a good feeling.
Yes, Lord.
He makes you glad. God makes you glad.
Make me want to go to church in here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right now. Yeah.
Because I am glad. I'm really glad about this song. This song gives me joy, gives me spirit. It gives me a change, you know, change is good.
Yeah.
So it's awesome. This is awesome. This is awesome, Cynthia. So let's talk more about this. I'm so glad. I can't stress enough that it's amazing. I'm glad that we had a chance to kind of play it over the interview so we can let the people hear your strong voice. I can hear Patty. I can hear just all of the singers that you called out a while ago. I can hear it in your voice, the strength of your voice and all those things. And so when someone listens to I'm So Glad, and let's just go into an example at this point. Someone's listening to I'm So Glad, and they've just got to the end of the song. What do you want them to leave the song with? So after they finish listening to it, what do you want someone to take away from I'm So Glad?
Just thanking God for his grace and just knowing that God will make you glad. And if they're not saved, hopefully they will turn their life over to Christ. And he will make them glad, just because it's just a feeling to that that I have. I just want everybody else to have it because it's a good feeling to know that he woke you up this morning, started you on your way. He didn't have to do it, but he did.
Yes, he did.
He brought you through all of your storms. You know, everybody's either in a storm or you're coming out of a storm or you're going into one.
I'm just glad
that through his grace and mercy, he brings me out. He makes me glad. So I just want everybody, touch somebody to help somebody.
All right now, I'm telling you something. Well, this song sure is going to touch somebody and help somebody. So, I mean, I can't stress enough. The song is great. The song is awesome. And I'm so glad that it's on our IAU playlist. I am
yes.
so glad it is on the
I'm
IAU
so glad
playlist.
To be a member. Thank
so
you
glad.
For having me. I'm,
so tell
I'm
us.
Blessed.
So as we move into the IAU playlist, as we move into IAU, what has your experience been like since you've been with IAU?
I'm enjoying it. I'm new to IAU, and my friend Leroy came on. We're writing great songs together. He's got some great songs on there. And I'm enjoying it. I really enjoy the chat room and getting to meet people and talk to people, and has the opportunity to have my song played on the playlist that is so powerful. I mean, all the artists on there are so great. I've saw some of your interviews, and the chance to network with people with like minds, it's just a great opportunity. You know, where people with yourself and Leroy, and I met Brian and Funk Kid and a couple other people online. it's just a great opportunity. And I heard some of the singers there, they just sound so good. And I listen to the playlist, and just makes me feel good, puts me in a good mood.
Yes, it does. And, you know, you are definitely a great addition to what we do. And we're thankful to have you. And just to let all your fans know that are out there in the fan land, that your song is not only on the IAU general playlist, but your song is also on the Spotify Christian/gospel playlist. It's also on the iTunes Christian/gospel playlist. And as we move into Pandora and all of the other networks that we're with Deezer and Napster, and place your songs on those, they'll be moved into that playlist as well. So fans, if you want to hear I'm So Glad, just type in on Spotify, IAU Christian Gospel Playlist. Type in on iTunes, if you have iTunes, IAU Christian Gospel Playlist, and you will find I'm So Glad by Cynthia Cooper. Such an awesome song, awesome songwriter, awesome singer, awesome all of the above. And they tell me, Cynthia, that you go to someone's church that's a major Grammy Award winner. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, I was blessed to join a Mount Calvary Church of Word of God. I've been a member there for about a year and a half now, and the wonderful Shirley Caesar Williams is my pastor, along with Bishop McNair, and it's just a wonderful church that I go to. It's a wonderful blessing to get fed. My soul gets fed, and it makes me glad again. I go there and I get glad. That's the feeling I have when you go to church. It just makes you glad. And
so glad.
She's an awesome pastor. Yes. She's an awesome pastor.
That's great. And so if you're watching this, Shirley Caesar, or if you get a chance to watch your member, Shirley Caesar, IAU appreciates you as well. I grew up on her music. She's a great singer, strong singer, storyteller, gospel singer. Oh yes, my gosh. Yes. I'd love to do an interview with her.
Yeah, I love my pastor.
And so I hope that if, you know, she see this video, that she knows that my mother appreciates her the most. And
yeah, I appreciate it.
Just so glad to have you on this interview and to know that you're in sync with such great people. So let's talk more about IAU. Where do you see IAU going? Do you see a potential future for IAU? Tell me about that. What is your future outlook for IAU?
I'm hoping to continue to network and meet other like minds and maybe collaborate on some songs together. You maybe do some shows together. Hopefully you'll do an IAU convention after the pandemic is over, and we can just get together and, you know, the like genres to get together and maybe work together, and then even unlike genres, everybody just get together
exactly
and have a big party and perform. I think that would be really good, and I'm looking forward to hearing my songs on Spotify and iTunes and you know, all the other wonderful social media that they have out there so it's a great opportunity to network, and I'm looking forward to working with you and doing some song with you.
Yeah, we owe each other a song, so.
Yeah.
So that's great, Cindy, and we once again appreciate you being on our network, coming along, bringing in people, moving forward in this process to actually help the indie artist. The indie artist has been ignored for years, but I think this is the year for the indie artist. So we're moving forward to help support and push you along with all other independent artists on our network. And if you're watching this and you're an independent artist and you don't have a home, you don't have a community to go to for support, you don't have a community to go to for interviews, you don't have a community to go to for promotions, this is your home. And so if you look at the bottom of the screen in the descriptions on this YouTube video, you'll see a link that you can join. And we also, for those who are out listening to this interview, if you're a fan or if you're not a musician and you just want to hear our playlist, if you look on the bottom of the descriptions, there is a playlist there, Spotify playlist and all different genres,
great.
And also a general playlist. And so guys, Click on that link and check IAU out, and especially check out our fabulous Cynthia Cooper. So as we come to a close in this interview, we want you to give us some words to an artist that may be just starting their journey, someone who needs some encouragement, someone, what kind of advice would you give to someone that's just starting off, or, you know, they want to be successful in the music industry?
Persistence is the key. I would tell them to continue to network. I would tell them to just keep recreating songs, stay into it, you know, because their perseverance is going to get them to that success. Continue to network and meet people, because that's how I met Patty and Billy Paul. I work with different musicians. I went to all the open mics, you know, just stay in the business, stay around people with like minds, join a network like IAU and network and meet a whole lot of people. You never know where somebody on the network might be able to introduce you to somebody in the industry. You know, it's a small world at the end of the day, just like you work with Fred Hammond, Dottie Peoples, you know a lot of people.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, so.
They ain't supposed to know that.
So I'm just saying, this is how it works. I work with people, you work with people. That's Leroy, right. he's worked with Blue Magic, you know, just a lot of people in your network that they've already worked with. And I'm sure if we talk about it more, we'll find out more.
Yes, you'll find out.
We have to communicate a lot more to find out what everybody's doing, because a lot of people don't know. I just found out about the chat. I wish I would have known sooner.
Yeah.
But networking, I would tell them just to stay inspired and just, you know, do your best and don't dare stop.
All right.
Halle Bell gave me an autograph and it says, "Cindy, I love your voice. Don't dare stop." And that's been keeping me going for all these years.
Right. Well, we appreciate your advice to all of the artists in our land. And I just want to reemphasize once again that Cindy's Cooper song, "I'm So Glad," is definitely on our playlist. And you can find her song, even off of our playlist, on Spotify. And soon you'll be able to find it on iTunes, you'll be able to find it on Pandora, you'll be able to find it on Deezer, and you'll be able to find it on Napster. So please stay in tune with Cindy, because her voice is amazing. And we're going to leave
this interview
with no better than the great song, "I'm So Glad." Hear ye, hear ye.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being with us, Cindy.
Thanks for having me. Yeah,
no problem.
I enjoyed it.